We are continuing with our weak acid strong base titration. We now want to know, what is the pH when 10 milliliters of 0.10 molar sodium hydroxide is added to 25 milliliters of 0.10 molar acetic acid? Realize that because we're continuing in our titration calculations, the same Ka value still applies. We still have the Ka for acetic acid as 1.8 times 10 to the minus 5. If this was asked as an independent question, that Ka value would be provided. When we did our beaker drawing and set up for this series of pH calculations, we did the beaker drawing for this region in our titration. Realize that we have excess acid and sodium hydroxide is our limiting reagent. I also asked you to set up your change tables for this one. And so to save a little bit of time, you should have the following setup. So first in here, I have a description of where we are in the titration. And I don't expect you to see that until maybe after you set up your change table. But realize that anytime we're before the equivalence point in a weak acid, strong base titration, this region is called the buffer zone. And that is because what we have left in solution at our final line in our change table is we have excess weak acid. I've used HA instead of acetic acid. We have leftover weak acid and we have produced the salt of its conjugate base. So again, anytime we're in region two before the equivalence point in a weak acid strong base titration, we have produced a buffer. Of course, we do have water that is formed in the reaction, but because it is neutral, it will not count towards our pH. So moving to the next slide, again, we have the same change table here. Now I'm going to work through the calculation. Because we have a buffer solution, remember the easiest way to calculate the pH of a buffer is to use our Henderson-Hasselbalch equation. We have this setup here where pH is equal to pKa plus the log of base over acid. And remember, for quantities here, for base over acid, we can use molarity, or we can use moles, or we can use millimoles. Because in my change table, I have quantities in millimoles already, I'm going to stick with that. Remember that pKa is calculated as the negative log of our Ka value. For acetic acid, that is, again, 1.8 times 10 to the minus 5, plus the log of my ratio of base to acid. And this is where we want to remind ourselves of which one is which. Again, remember the base, in this case, is going to be our salt. The sodium acetate is a basic salt, and so that will be our numerator. And of course, our acid has to be acetic acid. Again, using your nomenclature can help you figure that out. When we plug all of this into our calculator, we get a final value of 4.57. We're still calculating pH, so our same sig fig rules apply. Two sig figs in concentration gives us two decimal places in pH. To practice in this region, I would like for you to calculate the pH after we add 12.5 milliliters of sodium hydroxide. And realize when I give you volumes like that, we're not adding them to what we've already done. To do your setup for this one, instead of using 10 milliliters, this is where you would plug in 12.5 milliliters of NaOH. I want you to try that calculation. At the start of our next video, I will come back with the answer and worked solution.